All right, good morning. We are doing a classic strength and cardio workout today. Moderate weights. Take a nice big deep breath up. Big breathe, big deep breaths up, in and out. I'm gonna turn this up a little bit. All right. Good, couple more. Use this time to kind of set yourself up for a great workout. Good, and we're gonna hamstring curl and bicep curl. Good. We're gonna get nice and warm right away, about 4 minutes or so, maybe five of a warm up. Good. Eight more. Eight, seven. Warm up those biceps. Four more. We're gonna go leg back, tricep kick back, take it back. So we're warming up the back of the arms and the back of the legs. So I'm just taking that toe back a little bit, more lifting from the glutes. Eight more, warm up those triceps. Good. We're gonna tap those toes, arms to the side with a little circle. I actually feel my core a little bit here. So whatever direction you automatically went, just notice that, and now go the other way. I went back, now I'm forward. Feels a little bit less natural. Maybe sink down a little deeper into that knee bend. Four more. We're gonna hold those feet and we're gonna cat and cow, nice and slow. Take your time with it. Swoop it forward. So as you swoop forward, you're actually rounding and then extending. There's that cat cow. Two more. I'm gonna go right into a squat right here. So we're gonna go into a walkout. But get those squats going. Three, two, hold this one down there. Walk it out. Bring your knee in, right and left, and walk it back. Get those arms overhead and do that again. Just bringing the knee in. Once you get to your plank, I'm not running it, I'm just kind of pulling it in, sitting into those heels. Do that again. Maybe start with the other knee. Sitting into those heels before you come up is key. So I want you to sit into those heels, hold your next plank. Just hold it and go to downward facing dog and plank. Great way to warm up. The whole back of the leg. Hold your next down dog and pedal the heels or pump the heels up and down. So I like the pump up. I feel like it's a little bit more dynamic, but you can just pedal it out a little quick pace. Your heels might hit, they might not. Last one. Good, go to your plank and we're gonna launch your plank. So we're gonna launch back and plank forward. So it's a little, it's almost like a little crouch, okay? If you are really having trouble with it, go here into like a child's pose and then hit your plank, okay? So totally your option. That feels good for you. All right, we're gonna hold that plank. We're gonna bring our right foot to our right hand. Hold it there. Good. Just hold it. Just gonna get that good alignment. Good, put that back knee down, put your hand down, take this front foot and stretch it back. Remember we did this last week? So we go to that runner stretch, put that knee down, and then lift and push it back. Two more times. Great way to work on your hip mobility. Good, one more. Good. And now switch feet. Take the other foot forward, find that good alignment and hold it. Have your hands down or you can kind of press into it. Nice straight back leg with that nice runner stretch. Good, we're gonna put that hand down, back knee down, and then bring that leg back. This side feels a little stiffer for me. And do this three more times. You don't wanna rush it. Last one. And put that foot down. And then walk the other foot in and roll it up. Good job. Roll those shoulders back. And we are ready to go. Oh, it's hot in here. And I already have my fan on. Get a drink of water. I've been putting lemon in my water in the morning. Very good for you. It's like a detoxifier, great for your liver. So I try to add that into either my hot water or tea or my cold water. Feels good too, it tastes good too. All right, I'm gonna turn on my fitness tracker. I forgot to do that. We have 22 moves about, maybe a few more. No repeat, should have said that. No repeat, yay, unless we're doing something right and left. The first move is gonna be an offset. We did this kind of with a goblet squat. You're gonna have your right foot forward. I'm gonna have, you can be straight on, but I'm gonna pivot to this foot. I'm gonna have a weight in my back hand and we're gonna stagger squat to press. You have 45 seconds of all these moves. 40 to 45, okay? So I'm gonna take a 12. We're gonna do it on the right and then the left, okay? So my right foot's forward and I kind of have like a little pivot here. My back heel is up. Here we go. So your emphasis is on that front glute. I like having that little bit of an angle for my foot. It gives me a little more space to go down. Pick a pace you can stick with. Feel that core, get that really nice range of motion. This feels good on the body usually. So you can get a little lower, especially when we're warming the body up still with these first few moves. Push into that heel, you can have your hand out. Back is straight. Rest it up, one more. Take a break. And we are going right to the other side. Okay, put the weight out of your hand. Notice how the body feels. Should be a little winded. We're gonna go to the other side. Normally I would put a cardio move in here, but I didn't because I want to really get this move. It's like a good first move to do. All right, ready? Go. And I kind of want it to feel the same. If we did like a cardio move, you'd be all winded and you might be not feeling as good. I'm gonna show you from the side. Make sure you're pushing that weight right overhead. Looking good. So arm can be out. You should be really feeling your core. This is like a clean and press, but it's a staggered kind of open squat. You got 5 seconds. Nice little hip opener. Last one, put it down. Cardio, 2 jacks and a drop squat. So you can do 2 low and a step out and then just go to the other side if you wanna go low. This is gonna be 40 seconds. Ready? Here we go. 2 jacks, drop. Two arms. One arm, whatever feels good. But I want you to get low here. My arms are going up for the jack. You can touch down one arm, but we're going for it. Remember, it's not 30 seconds, it's 40. Longer interval. So that drop squat is a pause. Want your heels down, whether you're doing low or high. Last one, time. Whew. All right, bicep curl with a curtsy. We're gonna hold that curl for 2. Whew. I'm going 12s. It's an alternating move. I'm gonna take my right leg back. Here we go. Two, in. You can start whenever you're ready. So I'm not pulsing the arms. I'm holding the arms and I'm pulsing the curtsy, okay? You can do that with a hammer curl with the palms facing each other. Remember, we're not repeating any of these. We might repeat the muscle group, but not the actual exercise. Now, if you're a little winded like me, you have the right weight. But you could choose to go lighter today. Just pulse the legs, not the upper body. I don't want you, almost lost my balance there. I don't want you throwing the weight back. One more. And we'll finish up on the other side. And up. Whew, that one got me. All right. Cardio. Double hop. So it's hop, drop. Or you can do a two-step or a skater. It looks like this. Hop, drop. Hop, drop. Hop, drop. Hop, drop. So I'm on my toes in the middle, and then I sink to my heels. I keep going. 40 seconds. You can be step touch or two to each side. All right, we're doing two. Nice. I like the arms up. Now, when you are jumping like this, or even if you're not jumping, you need to really use that core because you're moving both legs at the same time. So high and low, battle rope arms, or pull down, whatever you want to call it, ear arms. Three, two, one. Whew. All right. Going down to the mat, skull crushers with a bridge march. If the march confuses you, just hold the bridge. I'm gonna go 10 pounds. So what we're doing is holding the bridge up and we're kicking the leg. If you don't like kicking the leg up, just pull it in. Either one, you're getting a little bit of glute, but you wanna keep those hips level. Or you can just hold your glute bridge. Elbows bent, hips up. Elbows over your shoulders. Here we go. If this confuses you, then just hold your glute bridge. No problem. Push into the heel that's on the floor, but you're not lowering the bridge. It's a bridge march. This is a great move, even if you did it without the arms. It's a great move to replicate like a plank if you don't like planks. You can also bring this knee in. Now on the skull crusher, keep going. I don't want you to bring the weights forward. Just go straight up, okay? Keep those hips up. 5 seconds. Triceps. A little slower. Last one. Woo, bring it in. All right. We're going to push-ups. Yeah. Push up to a bridge, alternate, or push up to a reach. Your call, okay? So here's your option. Push-up, reach. You can do push-up knees or toes. And if you do the push-up on your knees, you're gonna go to plank. Bring your foot in, bridge, reach, okay? Either one, go. I'm gonna do the push-up on my knees. I'm still not recovered from 100 push-ups the other day. And I really want to focus. Remember, your elbows go back. So you're walking that foot in. That takes time. Go to your plank, walk your foot in, put the heel down, push it up. Remember, you can do the alternating reach here too. Come on, this is your strength move. Make sure this feels good for your body. Nice, strong push-up. And one more. and time. Whew. All right. Come on up. Two drop squats, four kicks. Any kicks you want. You get 15, 20 seconds here. So two drop squats. I'm gonna mix up my kicks. I'm gonna do some front, some side. Here we go. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Make the drop squats quick. How are you doing? Again, you do whatever kicks you want. You can touch the toe on those kicks. If you're doing front kicks, use that core. Heel clicks. Again. You want it more intense? Okay. One more. And time. All right. Move nine. Renegade rows, or you can stand and alternate your row. I'm gonna do renegade row. And bent over row, alternating. I think maybe go a little heavier here, but I want you alternating to get that core response. You can do this knees or toes. Ready? Go. Lower with control and put that weight right underneath as best you can under your shoulder. Now, my hips are probably up a little bit. I have my feet wide. As long as I'm not rocking side to side, you can do it here. All right, I'm just showing you options. You keep going, okay? You can make it harder by bringing the feet closer. That's gonna be harder on your core so you don't shift those hips. You're working core and back. I want you to think about the back lifting the weight. You have to have tight abs here. Breathe. Elbow goes back and up. Don't twist, just bring that elbow back. Use your back. Last one. Definitely gets the heart rate up in a plank, or if you have heavier weights, standing up. All right. Come on up. Lateral lunge, weight in this hand. This leg steps out. Knee up. If you don't like the knee up, tap it in. Okay? Maybe you do some with the knee, some without. I'm taking a 12. Again, we're gonna do this one right and left before we get to that cardio move. Ready? This leg goes out. Nice big step. Push those hips back. Here we go. And if you don't want to overhead press, you can just clean it or hold it or here or here. You have so many options. What I don't want you to do is rush it. I want you to drive that knee up. Use that core when you look around. You play it safe on that one. You can tap and then knee up. 5 seconds. So don't let the weight pull you down when you go over here. Really lengthen through the back. Last one. Put it down. Get the weight out of your hand. You can go right to the other side. You should need this break. Feels good to get out of the hands. Ready? Let's go. Here we go. Test the waters. I want you to be careful when you put this foot down. Don't just slam it down. It's toe ball heel. Okay? It's a squat. Think about it. Even though it's a lateral lunge. So what I don't want is okay, a little more muscle slowness. I want you to work on getting that knee up. Even if you do one, that is an incredible core move. Okay? The more you focus, the better it will be. Some are better than others. Maybe find a focal point. Remember your options. One more. Knee up. And bring it down. Whew. Love that for balance. Not only works your balance, but it works your core. All right. You have choices here. You could take one weight and circle it, or circle without. And we're gonna, you can do this low or high impact. This would be your low, or you could jump it. Or if you didn't like that circle, maybe you push the weight overhead. I'm gonna take a 10, see how I feel. I'm gonna push it overhead first. Ready, alternating lunge. Go. From the side. I'm not letting the weight pull me down like this. Again, maybe a lightweight. You can circle. It's like a, not a halo, because you're staying in front, but it's more of an around the world. But with a heavier weight, you might not like it. Okay? I'm finding I just have to go a little slower. Feel my core. Woo, big time. I like it. Keep the weight in front of your head, not over it. In front of the body. 3, 2, 1. All right. Move 13, we're getting there. All right. Burpee. All right. We're gonna run up, burpee, run back, burpee, or you can jump it. If you don't want a burpee, squat, run, squat, okay? You can squat in place of the run, in place of the burpee. I'm gonna do a little bit of both. Ready? It's a half burpee. And go. You can jump it. You can do a high knee run. That's gonna activate a little more core, and it still adds a nice amount of impact, okay? Rather than just always jumping forward and running back, we're running forward, running back. How are we doing? So don't always do the same thing. I like the run because it gets my heart rate up and it also works my core. One more. Oh, finish it. Push into those heels. Time. Woo. Love those combo moves. All right. Light weights. Palms forward around the world. If you don't like to go overhead, you can do anything for shoulders. Upright row, lateral raise, front raise. I'm using 8s. Feet apart, tuck that pelvis under. Palms face forward, pinkies are close to each other, but not touching. And then the thumbs together at the top. Here we go. I'm gonna show you from the side. It's slow. Make sure you're not locking the knees, leaning back. Tuck the pelvis, because it's a big core move as well as shoulders. If you need a break at the bottom, do a shoulder roll in between. You're still working your shoulders. I like the dumbbells touch at the top, but you can leave them apart. So again, that's shoulder roll. Still working the shoulders. If you have a shoulder injury, weighted shoulder rolls are great. Tuck that pelvis. slow. Slower's harder. You only have a slight bend in the elbow. I'm not bending my elbows actively. One more. Come down slow and rest. Nice job. Haven't done that one in a while. All right. Another one. Five-step move. All right. We're going to go in a pulsing static lunge. 20 seconds, right leg forward, 20 seconds, left leg forward. You're gonna be pulsing a hammer curl with the pulsing lunge. If you don't like the pulsing lunge, just hold the lunge and switch. I'm gonna try 10s for this one. 20 seconds each leg. With me, it'll probably be 25. Right foot forward. And here we go. I'm finding the bottom with my arm. Okay, I'm not here, okay? This is really not good. So it's slow. Elbow points down. I'm feeling that front leg, your chest is up. Get ready to switch in 4, 3, 2, switch. You're on that railroad track. Again, if your arms are going to failure, you know, take them down for a second and just pulse and then bring them back. Chest is up. Doesn't have to be a deep lunge. You should be feeling your core. 3, 2, 1. Bring it up. Feeling all legs there. So I love these compound moves with moderate weights. They get the heart rate up. All right. Never done this one. I just wrote it down. 4 pendulum jacks, 4 staters. I don't know how it's gonna go. Here's the low. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Doesn't matter what side you're going to. All right, high impact, you switch the legs. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm counting a long way. It's really 8 and 4 skaters. So I would say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1. From the side. Don't overthink it. Remember, low. You can do 4, and then maybe 4 set catches. Give me one more. And 4. Finish with your 4 skaters. And time. Woo. All right, come on down. Kick back in a bird dog. We're doing 30 seconds each side. Actually, no. We're gonna do 40 each side, like a traditional thing. All right, 2 weights. You can have your hand on the dumbbell or on the floor. All right, get in all 4s, making sure you're not arched or rounded. Reaching through the crown of the head, try not to lift up. You'll feel tension in the neck. We're gonna lift our right elbow up and our left leg. The leg stays and we kick back, okay? We're kicking back for 40 seconds. If you don't like the leg up, you can be right here. See how both knees are down, okay? Keep going. If you really hate this position, do a single arm tricep kickback. You're not moving the leg. I like to flex my foot and your elbow stays high. I'm gonna show from the other side. You have 15 seconds left. 40 seconds each side. Ooh, almost lost it there. That's what happens when you don't have your core. I have my toe pointed. It's a little harder than flexing it under. Keep that elbow high and time. Stretch it back. We're going right to the other side. This is core and triceps. moderate weight. We don't need to go heavy here. Whew. All right, other side. I'm gonna face this way so you can see my arm a little more. Take that opposite leg back, making sure that your hip isn't rotated up. Hip is like a headlight down, arm comes up, kick. Now, some people like that toe under. See my back toe? If that gives you more stability, do it. I like to point my toe because I like that little extra challenge. I'm gonna slow down a little bit. So what can happen in this move is it can get very swingy. So I still want you to keep that kickback form in mind. You're not coming in all the way. Okay? Come on. How we doing? Oop. I'm just trying to remind you of things that could go wrong. You have to really squeeze your core here. Ooh, little bend. Big squeeze. Last one. Bring it in. You probably should have gone lighter on that one. All right, live and learn. Stretch it back. All right, we're coming up. Take a little stretch there. This one's a low impact move with a big punch to it. You're gonna lunge, knee, lunge, switch. Or you can kick, or you can tap. So you're gonna take this foot, you're gonna lunge, knee, lunge, switch. Lunge, knee, lunge, switch, go. You can lunge, kick, lunge. I really want you to focus on balance. See, I'm losing my balance already. Knee, lunge, switch. So I like the knee better. You're also on that railroad track. Keep that in mind. If your foot's back here, you're going to feel off balance. You don't have to tap down. You can do it straight up. I just like the tap down. You can work your speed, good form. You kind of get into it. I'm feeling better now. I'm lunging further back, but it takes a little while. Feet apart, make sure they're not together. You can kick there, or you can tap it in. That's a little easier than that knee. So you can tailor it and time. Love that one for a low impact move. All right, what are we doing? Okay, we're already at move 20. Deadlift with a lateral raise. Now you're not gonna go as heavy as you would for probably a regular deadlift. If you wanna go heavy for deadlifts, do that here and just come up with a calf raise, okay? I'm gonna go 10s here, okay? Because I love this move. Deadlift, lateral raise. Deadlift, if you don't like the lateral raise, you can throw in an upright row, okay? Depends what you wanna work today. You can also keep the weights at the side for your deadlift. It's not a squat. Normally I prefer to have my palms facing each other, but you play around with it. Since my weights are moderate, I'm gonna come up both together, but I'm gonna try to challenge myself and come down slow. Reach to the crown of the head. Come on. We only have a few more moves. Whew. And then we're gonna go right into core. From our last move. Core is tight here. Remember, if you're a deadlift person, you wanna go more heavy with the legs, do that. Just do your deadlift. Keep your wrist straight. Don't let the weights pull your hand down. Last one. Big core move on that when those weights are to the side. Nice job. All right. Crescent, burpee. So sometimes you do like a knee twist. This is a crescent knee squat burpee. Okay. Feels good. You can also make it a crescent kick. All right. I'm going to show them from the front. So we're going to take this leg up crescent. Great way to incorporate and hip. My favorite thing is about this move is that it forces you to come up. Keep going. Good. Keep going. I know. Sometimes when I come up to the camera, I think you guys are like, did we start yet? But we are starting. I may show the first few and then we go. But I totally get that. We don't want to start ahead. You want to make it a kick? Oh, I almost kicked my furniture. Great way to get hips in. Three. Cool. Maybe one more. Nice. All right. All right, we're going to a core move. These last two are core, and then we go right into core on the floor. One dumbbell. We're gonna do a plank drag, okay, with two leg lifts in that plank. All right, so you're gonna be in a plank. You're gonna lift right leg and left leg, and then you're gonna drag it under. It looks like this. I'm in a plank. I'm gonna go lift, lift, drag. Lift, lift. Try your best to keep those hips down. It's a hard one. If you don't like it, you can do it on your knees. Lift, lift. And then maybe go to the plank for the drag, okay? You have so many options. So sometimes when I see the drag, we turn. Your point is to be in your plank and use your eyes, your peripheral vision to reach, not reaching underneath, if you know what I mean. Finish one more. That is slow, that little raise. I'm gonna do one more because I took a little break there. Okay, time. All right. Whew. All right. We're gonna do a cardio move and then we stay down on the floor for most of everything else. Okay, what is the cardio move? Okay. I'm torn. All right, two half burpees, in, out, come up four skaters. I love these combo moves. All right, so we're gonna come down. So we go in, out, one, two, three, four. In, out. You break it up however you want. So I'll do it from the side. Sometimes I do three, depends what you want. So here's three, one, two, and then come in on the third and stay. You can also take this back and up. So you can go up your skater and then go back. Okay, one more. Finish with your skater. Oh. Bring it down. Nice job. May have been more than 22, maybe 24. I think I added a bonus one there. All right. The first one is a little bit more for chest. Go with your moderate weight. Chest fly with a bicycle. I'm gonna go 10. Because I want to keep a good pace. Normally in a chest fly, if I was going to do it in my strength class, I would use 12, maybe 15. Okay. So So this is the start of your core section. Okay. Chest fly with the bicycle. Just go at your own pace. Your head is down. Knees bent. Here's your chest fly. Add that bicycle. One knee in, one knee out. These are all gonna be 35 seconds. So it's not a lot of time. If you're feeling tension in your head, just realign those shoulders. So again, this is not my heaviest weight. I'm just getting a little bonus in the chest and the shoulders, but I really wanna keep the pace up. So I have my lighter weights here. Three, two, one. Bring it in. Good job. Go to a side plank on your knee and your elbow. And behind your head, we're gonna circle that leg forward. We're just gonna stay right here. You'll be surprised at how much this one works your core. I'm circling forward, you can circle back, you can do any combination. Try to keep your ear off your shoulder. Option, if you're finding it difficult, maybe you're here, okay? Keep going. Nice big circle. And time, other side. Gonna keep it moving. This is like a best of core. Go, 35 seconds. You can do like maybe 8 forward, 8 back. It's really up to you. Having the hand behind my head makes it harder than just kind of not having any connection there. Ooh, really squeeze that core tight here. Four, three, two, one. Bring it on your back. Cross the ankles. Hip lift and lower. I'm gonna keep my head up the whole time. If lowering the heels arches your back, don't go down as low. Nice and slow. Crunch and bring it down. Now make sure you're not holding tension in your ankles. Keep going, switch your ankles. I just like to have a little evenness. Again, you don't have to drop down all the way. That's hard on your lower abs. So if you're feeling an arch in the back or it hurts your back, just do the hip lift and then maybe just come right to here. Okay, two more. I'm not pulling on my head. And time. Get your light weights. I'm gonna take 8s here. It's gonna be a chest press with a sit-up. I'm gonna have my feet apart. Chest press. I'm going a lot lighter than I normally would, but I want you to sit up. 35 seconds, come on. If you don't want to do the full sit up here, maybe you just go here or here, okay? So it's like a chest press to an overhead press. Try not to lean back. My legs are straight. You can have bent knees. Three, two, and one. Put it down. One of my faves. Knees bent, hands behind your head. We're gonna crunch and kick, okay? One side at a time. The other leg is just down. If you wanna make it harder, sit up and touch the toe, crunch the knee, sit up. Try not to pull on your head. Again, this is fine, but you're really very in control of your leg, okay? When you lower it with control. Keep that knee soft. Working that quad a little bit there. Really get that nice crunch. One more. We're gonna go right to the other side. Here we go. I like to do a couple of these. I'm gonna get my bearings. Hard to come up when this foot's on the floor. And it's harder on this side for me, as you can see. Knee. Don't be too quick to just touch your knee with your elbow. Make sure you're getting a nice twist there. Find that spot where you feel the most oblique work. I go to the outside of my knee when I remember it. Outside. Head can go down in between, but try to work on that neck strength. Last one. Whew. All right. All right, no equipment for this one either. We're gonna go 4 pumps. Sit up. All right, you can go 1, 2, 3, 4 and sit to boat. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's your hollow hold, okay? If you want, you can be here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Reach, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. So go. This is gonna be a little easier. You can go 1, 2, 3, 4. Crunch, crunch, okay? Hollow hold is gonna be your hardest. 1, 2, 3, 4. I like to tap my heels. It's like a little tuck. But you get that nice hollow hold, 100. You can also do it with your knees bent. 2 more. 1 more. We probably did more than 35 seconds, but I gave you lots of options and time. Whew. All right. Okay, sprinter sit up. You can take a weight. This is your last move. I'm gonna take a 10. Now if you want, you can pull over, crunch, pull over, crunch. It's gonna be easier. You can do pull over, sit up. Or you can keep the weight close to your chest. That's gonna be a little harder to roll down and up. So keep going with whatever version you're doing. I'll show you them again. Pull over, sit up. If you struggle with coming up without having your arms over your head, do this. But I want you to think of it as functional. Try to come up on your own, okay? You can also crunch here. You're still working, it's still hard, okay? One more. End time. If you want, little bonus move to try. Hollow to crunch, hollow to crunch. You can do it with one foot. Okay, it's a good one to try. You can come all the way up. Little bonus move I didn't expect to do, but the other move allowed me to think of this move because it's good when you don't have any weight. Crunch. One more. And pull it in. Nice job. All right. Whew. Let's sit up nice and tall. Good job, everybody. Hands under your knees. We're gonna round the back. And then we're gonna come forward and arch. It's like a little cat and cow in this position. Round. And come up and bring your chest, shine your chest forward. It's not much of an arch, but it'll give your abdominals a nice little stretch. Hope you enjoyed that. We're gonna finish cooling down. One more time, finish here. Good. Bring your right hand down, left arm up and over. Kind of just take that side stretch. Try to get as long as you can here. Other side, lift up and then over. Notice if your arm's in front, really try to get a nice lateral bend here. Try to relax your head. Go a little deeper as you exhale. Come on up. Good, let's take a spine twist. I like to do it in this position sometimes. My hand is very close to my back, or you can just hold both hands by the knee and twist. Other side. Take that twist, get open through the shoulders, making sure that you're not having tension in your head by looking behind you. You're only looking a little bit off on a diagonal. You can use this hand to get a little more twist. Take those legs out. Stretch your hamstrings. Hinge forward first. Get that nice stretch through the low back as well, and then fold over your legs. Fold yourself in two. You can hold on to your toes, your heels. So, I don't know if you saw, I'm starting a 4-week beginner Pilates. Great for beginners, great if you want to delve into Pilates. 4 weeks, every Monday, 11 o'clock on Zoom. If you can't make the live, you can get the replay. I have early bird pricing until Friday. I'll be going live about it again today. And there is a link on my Instagram and Facebook pages. Roll it up. So, heels together. Take a little butterfly stretch. So it's a great way to introduce Pilates to your workout routine, or if you're new to exercise, it's a great starting point because you're going to have so much more mind-body connection. I infuse Pilates into everything I do, so it's very natural to take what you learn in Pilates and adapt it to any workout, whether it's walking, to running, to strength training, or HIIT training. All right, let's come on to all fours. So if you have any questions, you can message me about that. I am posting this video on my YouTube page today. So if you have any questions, it's going to start June 3rd, every Monday. And I'm also adding a little 15-minute healthy habit talk because they go hand in hand. It's a good reminder for everybody, whether you have a well-established fitness routine. I know I need little reminders here and there. So, but it's good to kind of get on track for the week. Turn those toes under, bring your hips back, down dog, and then walk your feet to your hands or your hands to your feet, roll it up, big shoulder roll, big deep breath, hands to your heart. Thank you for joining me today. I'm going to turn this off because I've got to get on to my day, and I'm sure you have to get on to your day.